In this pro tip, we're going to take a look at Git Interactive Rebase. Git Interactive Rebase allows you to change individual commits, squash commits together, drop commits, or change the order of the commits. This allows you to clean up your Git commit history to make it linear and meaningful, which can make it easier to understand the history of the project in the future. Let's take a look at how this works. Open the Git window using Command and 9 on Mac, or Alt and 9 on Windows and Linux. In the Git log window, we can see the commits that were made to the project. In this example, we use TDD, test-driven development, to add a new feature. We start by adding a failing test, writing the minimum of code we need to get that test to pass, and finally do some refactoring. Even though we made the necessary changes in multiple commits, we don't need to keep all these individual commits for future reference. In the Git history, identify the commit from where you want to clean up your history, so the oldest commit, in this case the first failing test that we added. Right-click on that commit and select Interactively Rebase from here. This will open a pop-up window with a list of commits that were done on top of the selected commit. When we select a commit, we can see the details of that commit just as we can in the regular Git log window. Notice there are several options at the top of this pop-up that become active when we select one or more of the commits. Reword allows us to change the commit message of a specific commit. The squash button is actually a drop-down that allows us to choose between squash and fix-up. Both options will combine the changes made in the selected commits into one commit. If we select squash, by default the individual commit messages will be combined. If we select fix-up, the commit message of the fix-up commit will be discarded. You can select fix-up with Option and F on Mac, or Alt and F on Windows and Linux. Drop allows us to drop one or more commits. Let's say we want to change the order of the commits. We want to keep the unrelated change, but separately from the changes for the new feature. We can select this commit and use the up and down buttons on the top left to change where in the order this commit will be. Let's reorder the commits. Once we're sure about the order, select Start Rebasing. We see that the order of the commits has changed. Next, we want to combine multiple commits where we added the tests and the new feature. Let's select those commits. Now, because we want to combine those commits into one commit with one commit message, we select Fix Up and then select Start Rebasing. We see that multiple individual commits are now combined into one commit with one commit message. Finally, we want to drop the commit with a mistake that we made. Select the mistaken commit, select Drop, and select Start Rebasing. We see that the commit is dropped. Now we know how to clean up our commit history with Git Interactive Rebase. Thank you for watching.